Welcome to MCTV Live.
I'm Stephanie Schneider.
And I'm Colin Gaumont.
Today we've got a really good show for you. We have the 2004 Municipal Election Report.
We got an Alanis video.
We have JV Volleyball video.
And an Entertainment Report.
And closing up, we have the WCC opening credits. Promise to be a good show.
It's going to be a good one tonight.
So hopefully you'll enjoy it and stay tuned. Here we go in right about now.
Let's go.
Bombs away!
Welcome back.
All right, this week the highlight would be Friday, which is going to be our Halloween day. So you come to school, you dress up, and you can win a prize for best costume. What are you going to go as, Colin?
I actually don't know. I'm kind of a last minute person. I just never know what I'm going to go as.
That's all good. Me, it's surprise, not exactly, like, I'm sure, but hopefully it'll be a good one. Really a great thing.
Here we go with our Alanis video.
Oh, it's the election report.
Here we are at the Rendezvous Center where the 2004 Mournville Municipal candidates are holding a public reform for the election on October 18th.
The completion of the Open Space and Recreation Master Plan created a 10-year strategy for the implementation and construction of those amenities in Mournville. The first phase, which includes both the water and skateboard parks, has finally been approved by council and will be constructed next year.
Candidate Lloyd Birchie seems to be concerned about the youth of Mournville and that we should have more programs to keep us busy.
As mayor, I will promote Mournville as a community that understands values and promotes its arts, culture, and volunteerism. We cannot forget those whose passions and tremendous volunteer efforts have built this community.
Candidate for mayor, Randy Opolinski, seems very concerned about the support in our community with volunteerism, art, and culture, and that we keep it going. And with the opening speeches brought questions from the floor.
What are we going to do to make our streets more safe?
The town participated jointly with the school board, both in Mournville here, the Greater Catholic Center School Board, as well as the Sturgeon School Board, and brought a police liaison officer to the community that spends 3 days a week, two in the high school, one in our junior high school, the other two at Sturgeon Con.
That is not going to solve my problem. I want you to address this issue to get my vote. Otherwise, I will stay at home and I won't vote.
So if we provide some kind of community-based place where teenagers can go watch a movie, have a dance, whatever, it'll be better than they're off the streets and they're not doing anything in our town that we're ashamed of.
After the speeches and the questions, we had the privilege of interviewing some candidates.
We wanted to ask you about if there was any other plans for recreational facilities in Mournville, even around the area.
Yeah, right. Council in the last year has put together a comprehensive plan that through Randy Conrad Associates. It's got multi-use center, aquatic center, indoor soccer. We also approved the skateboard park and splash pads.
So now that you've had an inside look at the 2004 municipal election, who would you vote for? And who do you think will win? This has been Stephanie Schneider for an MCTV production.
Hi, welcome back. That was a good piece done by Brianne Ricard, myself, and Nadine Ricard. And a follow-up on that, the new mayor of Mournville, who was actually our mayor last year, is Lloyd Birchie.
Yeah, he did a very good job last year for Mournville, did a lot, and I think he'll do very good this year, too.
Yeah, he brought a lot to this community. Up next, we have the Alanis video by Suzanne and Lauren, and the rain one. What's that one called again?
It's called Ironic. It's a good one. Here it is.
All right.
Thank you. In this music video, Alanis Morissette really captures her own contradictions by showing herself as various people.
Just a very clever premise, executed really well. You've got yellow Alanis, you've got green Alanis, you've got black Alanis, you've got red Alanis.
In some ways, the video is saying, yeah, she's coping with representations of herself by laughing. And hey, I'm all for that.
Welcome back. That was a very good video, but I am very excited for Halo 2 coming out. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
Colin. Yeah. Anyways.
Anyways, up next we have our JV volleyball report. Guys are off to a little shaky start, but a little practicing and hard work, and they should really come through.
I think they'll do good this year. I've got faith in these guys.
Yep. So here's the report and some interviews, and here we go.
Hi, I'm Nick Zielinski. In MCHS, the junior volleyball season has just started. The boys kind of off to a bad start after going to two tournaments and finishing last in both of them. But the girls, in their first tournament, won gold in the first one and got second in the second tournament. Does this team have a future?
Team leader. They need to come together.
How do your first two tournaments go?
Well, they went all right. They weren't the greatest ever. We lost most of our games, but we did played good.
How did your first two tournaments go?
Really good. We won our home tournament.
I think they got a lot of talent.
What do you need to improve your team?
What do we need to improve on is our serving, our passing, and setting needs to work on.
Any improvements for the teams?
I think the team's come a long way since the first practice.
See, what I think of the Morinville JV team, they're awesome.
Does this team have a future?
Oh, we do. We're going to win next week and can win every game.
Looks like the season is almost over. JV boys had a little rough season, but the girls had an excellent season. Volleyball's now over, basketball's coming right.
Hi, welcome back.
And today, in our box office, our top three, we got number one, The Grudge, number two, Shark Tale, number three, Team America, World Police.
Yeah, and in the Entertainment Report, Team America, World Police, and Ladder 49 were the features. And this week out on video, we have Dawn of the Dead, the 1978 remake. We have White Chicks. We also have Grand Theft Parsons. And so here, let's take a look at our Entertainment Report.
Good afternoon, and welcome to MCTV's Entertainment Report. I'm Kevin Hammond. With me, I'm a special guest host, Michael Barstow. And we're going to review the movies, Ladder 49, Team America, World Police. So, Ladder 49, Mike, what do you think of the movie?
I found it very exciting and true to the heart of firemen everywhere.
Definitely. Good tribute to 9/11. Definitely a good movie. Rates up there with Backdraft.
Very good acting. I liked John Travolta and Joaquin Phoenix.
It was a very good movie.
We
don't know what it's about. It's about this guy who falls inside of a building, and then he has all these memories, but when he was a rookie and stuff like that. It's a very funny movie, also very emotional. It's a very good movie.
And now we have a clip.
People are always asking me, how is it that firefighters run into a burning building when everyone else is running out? Courage is the answer.
Stationary firefighter Jack Morrison reporting, sir.
How you feeling, kid?
We have a thing here. A priest comes around twice a year. We all go to confession. In this job, you need it.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned.
Impure thoughts?
Well, yes, quite a bit.
You think it's funny to be with loose women?
These are the men of Ladder 49.
This station is the most disciplined firehouse in the city.
Everyday heroes.
I'm proud of you, baby.
Devoted to their families.
You ever consider babysitting full time?
What do you think I'd do at the firehouse?
And dedicated to saving the lives of strangers.
Grab her leg!
Come on, breathe. Come on.
I got something.
Alright, welcome back. Well, last weekend, great weekend for volleyball.
Yeah, we had the WCC here in Morinville, and it was presented by the Lions Club.
And for the guys, Bev Basie took it home this year, and for the girls, Rivers East.
It was some really good games, lots of action, great thing to watch. Did you watch some of the games?
Yes, I did. It was amazing volleyball. Big blocks, big spikes, great serves. It was amazing.
Yeah, all right, and now we have the WCC opening credits, so
here
let's have a look.
Thank you.
Welcome back, and that's about all for us today at MCTV Live. It's been a good show.
We've had a great show today, great videos, and it's been a good show.
Yeah, well, lots of great pieces by our own students here at MCHS, and next week we will expect the same thing, and hopefully you can come back, stay tuned, same time, place.
November 3rd is our next show, so.
Yep, November 3rd at lunchtime, so come check it out, and that's all for us.
Stephanie Schneider. We'll see you next time, and I'm Colin Gaumont.
See ya.